The React ecosystem is evolving, and with React 19 and Next.js 15 on the horizon, a major shift is coming. React server components. But here's the thing, there's still a lot of confusion out there. The docs are thorough, but they can be tricky to understand. This has led to some common misunderstandings, especially for beginners. In this video, we're going to debunk 5 common misconceptions about React server components that will help you confidently explore the new features in the upcoming versions. Let's start with a refresher on the 2 component types in the new RSC paradigm, server and client components. Server components run only on the server and have 0 impact on bundle size. Their code is never downloaded to clients, helping to reduce bundle sizes and improving startup time. In contrast, client components are the typical components you're already used to. They can access the full range of React features like state, effects, access to the DOM, etc. With this in mind, let's look at our first misconception. Server components should be preferred and client components should be used sparingly. You might think that to get the most benefit from the new RSC architecture, you should convert all the components to server components. However, the optimal approach is actually more balanced. While server components offer many benefits, they are not suitable for all scenarios, especially those requiring interactivity. React server components are a new type of React component that operates exclusively on the server, fetching data and rendering entirely on the server to improve performance. Client components are essential for features that need client-side interactivity, state management, or browser APIs. The recommended practice is to place client components as low as possible in the component tree, ideally making them leaf components. Let's move on to the second misconception. Use client marks a component as a client component, and use server marks a component as a server component. You might assume there is a symmetry in how we declare server and client components. The reality is a bit different. Use client does indeed mark a boundary for client components. However, there is no corresponding use server directive for marking server components. Server components are the default in Next.js app router and React server components paradigm. It is worth noting that a use server directive does exist, but it serves a different purpose. It's used for marking server actions, not for declaring server components. By making server components the default, React encourages a server-first approach, allowing you to leverage server-side rendering benefits without additional effort. Misconception 3. Server components always render on the server, and client components always render in the browser. At first glance, you might assume there is a clear-cut separation between where server and client components render. Traditional React components typically render on the client side, but with the introduction of server and client components, the rendering process has become more nuanced. Server components do indeed render on the server. However, client components are more versatile than you realize. They can render on both the server for the initial page load and the client. The key distinction lies in their capabilities. Client components can use client-side features such as state, effects, and event handlers, whereas server components cannot. Pre-rendering client components on the server significantly improves both the perceived loading speed and the actual performance of your application. It is also beneficial for search engine indexing. You might think that each component with any client-side behavior needs its own use client directive. However, this isn't the case. You only need to add use client at the top of the file for the topmost component that requires client-side features. All components defined in that file automatically become client components. This includes nested components, as well as utilities and functions within the file. In the component tree shown here, formattext.jsx, originally a server component, is executed client-side when imported into dashboard.js, which is a client component marked by the use client directive. Since JavaScript modules can be shared between both server and client components, it's possible for code intended only for the server to end up running on the client. Understanding these nuances helps you structure your application more securely and efficiently. And for the final misconception, Server components cannot be nested inside client components. You might think that once you've crossed into client component territory, you can't go back, and therefore server components cannot be nested inside client components. But there's more flexibility than you might expect. While you can't directly nest server components inside client components, you can pass server components as props to client components. This approach allows for a seamless integration of client and server components, optimizing both performance and interactivity. One common pattern is known as the children as props pattern, where the server component is passed as the children props to the client component. This allows us to have the best of both worlds, the power of server-side operations with the responsiveness of client-side interactivity. Remember, the introduction of React server components doesn't mean you need to radically change how you build React apps overnight. Instead, see it as a powerful new tool in your developer toolkit, one that you can gradually adopt and experiment with to optimize your React application. Make sure to check out my Next.js playlist for a complete understanding of React server components.